Hi guys, welcome to Number X. Today we are going to learn about different types of notations used for representing differential of a function. If you enjoy this video, don't forget to like it and subscribe to our channel. Post any questions or suggestions you have in the comments below. In differential calculus, there is no single uniform notation for differentiation. Instead, several different notations for the derivative of a function or variable have been proposed by different mathematicians. The most common notation for differentiation are Leibniz notation, Lagrange's notation, Euler's notation, and Newton's notation. Let us learn these notations one by one. Let y is a function of x which is equal to x to the nth power. In Leibniz notation, first derivative of the given function is denoted by dy over dx and second derivative is denoted by d2y over dx squared. On similar fashion, nth derivative is denoted by dny over dx to the nth power. One of the most common modern notations for differentiation is Lagrange's notation. In this notation, first derivative is denoted as f prime of x, second derivative is denoted as f double prime of x, and third derivative is denoted as f triple prime of x. Lagrange's notation of derivative is also called prime notation due to use of prime sign over there. But what about fourth derivative or higher derivative? It is denoted by using either Roman superscript or natural number enclosed in parentheses. So, nth derivative is denoted by f of x and n at right top corner of letter f enclosed in parentheses as superscript of f. In Euler's notation, the first derivative of the function f is denoted by d sub x of f. Here subscript x means function is being differentiated with respect to variable x. Second derivative is denoted as d sub x squared of f. Third derivative is denoted as d sub x cubed of f. Similarly, nth derivative is denoted as d sub x to the nth of. Finally, Newton's notations for differentiation places a dot over the dependent variable. Here y is function of x, hence x is independent variable and y is dependent variable. On top, a single dot over y denotes the first derivative of the function and two dots over y denotes second derivative of the function. Similar things happens with third derivative also. Due to use of dots on top of dependent variable, Newton's notation is also called dot notation of differentiation. But what about higher derivatives? In Newton's notation, fifth derivative is denoted by a dot beneath 5 on top of y. Similarly, nth derivative is denoted by a dot beneath n on top of y. The usefulness of each notation varies with the context, and it is sometimes advantageous to use more than one notation in the given context. For example, Leibniz notation allow one to specify the variable for differentiation in the denominator. This is especially helpful when considering partial derivatives. It also makes the chain rule easy to remember and recognize. Lagrange's notations are preferred when a function has two independent variables. Also, it is more compact notation than Leibniz notation. Euler's notation is useful for stating and solving linear differential equations as it simplifies presentation of the differential equation, which can make seeing the essential elements of the problem easier. Newton's notation is generally used when the independent variable denotes time. If location y is a function of t, then single dot over y denotes velocity and double dots over y denotes acceleration. This notation is popular in physics and mathematical physics. By end of this, we have finished this lecture. To get more videos like this, please subscribe to our YouTube channel Number X and hit the like button. You can share this video to other person and provide your valuable feedback in the comment box. So thanks for watching, and I am looking forward to see you in the next lecture.